Hello everyone, I am Divarani Pandurang Babar, working as an assistant professor at AISSMS IOIT Pune. In this presentation, we will try to understand this very important topic, that is Cartesian product. Sometimes we want a collection of ordered pairs. Let's say we are interested in finding all possible combinations of x and y coordinates where x and y values should not exceed 3. Now, see here. Here we have to find out all the possible combinations of x and y coordinates. Now, see here. These are all the ordered pairs. First value is for x coordinate and second value is for y coordinate. So these are the all possible combinations of x and y coordinates. That is 1,1, 1,2, 1,3, 2,1, 2,2, 2,3, 3,1, 3,2, 3,3. Now here A, B for any A and B is called as an ordered pair. Now, why I am calling this an ordered pair? Because let me tell you that order does matters. Here, the order of A and B does matter. One important note, see here, A, B and B, A are not equal. One important note is there, that is A, B and B, A are not equal. Let's try to understand this with example. Why is this the case that AB is not equal to BA? Here you can see in this graph, this point is 1,3 and this point is 3,1. You can clearly see that 1,3 is not equal to 3,1. Therefore, A, B and B, A are not equal. Hence, it is an ordered pair. Here, order does matters. Now, we will see the definition of Cartesian product. Now, see here, A and B are the two sets. Then Cartesian product of A and B, it is denoted by A cross B. And it is the set of all ordered pairs A, B, where A belongs to A, that means set A, and B belongs to B, that means set B. Or we can represent the definition of Cartesian product as A cross B is equal to all ordered pairs, that is A, B, such that A belongs to A, that means A is an element of the set A, and B belongs to B, that means B is the element of set B. This is the definition of Cartesian product. Now we will see one example. What is the Cartesian product of A is equal to 1,2 and B is equal to A, B, C? Now see here, two sets are available. In set A, two elements are there, 1,2, and in set B, three elements are there, A, B, C. Here you have to find out Cartesian product of A and B. Okay, so you have to take first element from the first set, that is 1, and you have to mention this element with all the elements of set B. Okay, now see here, Cartesian product of A, B, it is denoted by A cross B. Now first element from the set A is 1, okay, and first element from the set B is A. So here 1, A, afterwards second element from the set B is 2, so 1 comma B. Third element from the set B is C, so 1 comma C. And afterwards second element from the set A is 2, so 2 comma A, 2 comma B and 2 comma C. This is the Cartesian product between A and B. One more important notice there, that is A Cartesian product B is not equal to B Cartesian product A. Consider one more example. Set A is having two elements 1 comma 2 and B is having two elements 3 comma 4. Then what will be the A Cartesian product B? 1 comma 3, 1 comma 4, 2 comma 3, 2 comma 4. Then same, you have to find out the Cartesian product between B, A. So here you have to take first element from the set B. So 3 comma 1, 3 comma 2, 4 comma 1, 4 comma 2. Now check here. A cross B is not equal to B cross A. Now, one more important notice there. For any two non-empty sets A and B, if there are n elements in A and m elements in B, then the number of ordered pairs in A cross B will be mn. Suppose we are having two non-empty sets A and B, and in the set A n elements are present, and in the set B suppose m elements are present, then suppose you want to calculate what will be the number of ordered pairs present in A Cartesian product B, then it is m into n. Now see one example. Set A having two elements A comma B and set B having three elements P, Q, R. Now here just you have to find out the number of ordered pairs in A cross B. Now see here, first set, that is A, has two elements, and in the set second, that is set B, contains three elements. So there are two different ways in which we can fill this position for set A, and there are three different ways in which we can fill this position for set B. So for each and every element of set A and B, we have to calculate the number of ordered pairs, that is m into n. That means number of elements present in set A into number of elements present in the set B. So two elements are present in set A and three elements are present in set B. So 2 into 3 is equal to 6. So number of ordered pairs in A Cartesian product B will be 6. One more notice there. Phi cross A is equal to A cross phi is equal to phi. Now see the definition. That means we have already seen the definition of Cartesian product. Phi cross A is equal to, for all ordered pairs such that A belongs to phi and B belongs to A. Now see here, there is no such a pair A comma B where A belongs to phi and B belongs to A. That means A is a not element from the empty set. Okay, so we can say that A cross phi is equal to phi, and therefore phi cross A is equal to A cross phi is nothing but the phi. So this is all about the Cartesian product. Thank you.